Hello students, in this video let us discuss E1CB reaction. Okay, so generally there is a deuterium exchange. Hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium in a E1CB reaction. Okay, if you take the deuterated base and the solvent, here hydrogens can be replaced by the deuterium, okay, along with the elimination. But in a E1 reaction, E2 reaction, deuterium exchange, we can't see. Okay, so first of all, here what is the E1CB mechanism? Here E1CB mechanism is favored by the presence of the electron withdrawing groups like carbonyl group or NO2 or CN, okay, or CF3 or CCl3 electron withdrawing groups are favor the E1CB mechanism. Okay, here this group must be a poor leaving group. Okay, poor leaving group means here a fluorine, OR and OPH, they are the poor leaving groups. When there are the poor leaving groups and when there are the electron withdrawing groups in the substrate, this molecule on reaction with the base, for suppose I am taking KOH, alkali KOH, this follows the E1CB mechanism, unimolecular conjugate base elimination. That means here this elimination is carried out through the conjugate base formation. So here this base remove this proton, because this is the acidic proton due to presence of the electron withdrawing groups. So here ZCH minus and CH2, then here halogen. It is a conjugate base actually. Okay. The first step is a fast step. Removal of the proton is a fast step. Okay. So now here in this case, furtherly, this one, leaving of the poor leaving group. So here, ZCH double bond CH2. It is a slow step actually. It is a slow step. That means here, in this slow step here, only one molecule is involved. That's why its molecularity is one. Okay, that's what is called a unimolecular elimination reaction. But this unimolecular elimination reaction is proceed to the conjugate base anion formation. But in general, E1 reaction can proceed through the formation of the carbocation. But here, this E1 reaction proceeds through the formation of the carbanion, nothing but conjugate base. That's why this reaction is called as a unimolecular conjugate base elimination. Okay. This elimination, this E1 reaction proceeds to the formation of the carbanion. In general, E1 reactions proceeds to the formation of the carbocation. Okay, that's it. So, molecularity one, that's why it is a unimolecular conjugate base elimination reaction. Now, here I am taking one example, this one, NO2, CH2 and CH2, fluorine. Okay, so in this case, this one on reaction with C2H5ONa and C2H5OD actually, okay, deuterated solvent. Now here in this case, differently we can see this product C double bond CH2 and here deuterium. Okay, and in this case actually here hydrogen. So for suppose C2H5ONa C2H5OH, now in this case also E1CB reaction, but here the product is this hydrogen retained. This means your hydrogen remains same. But here when you use this deuterium solvent, here that hydrogen replaced by the deuterium. How that hydrogen replaced by the deuterium? Let us see this one. Or suppose in a first step, the C2H5O minus Na plus, this one remove the acidic proton, so NO2 CH minus and CH2F. Okay, now here this one readily accept the C2H5OD, that means deuterium, from the solvent. So here NO2 CHD and then CH2F, this process repeated one more time. So here NO2 CD2 CH2F, and then here as is an elimination reaction. Okay, that means here again in this case C2H5ONa that remove the deuterium and leaving out the fluorine. So here in this case you will get this product, okay, because though the hydrogens are acidic in nature, that's why that deuterium, that exchange, we can say hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium. If it is a E2 reaction, okay, for suppose you see this one here, CH3 and CH2, for suppose it is a bromine good leaving group and there is no electron withdrawing group in this reaction, in this molecule. So here, for suppose this one on heating with C2O5Na and C2H5OD, even though deuterated solvent is taken, here we cannot see the deuterium in the product because it is a direct E2 reaction. It is a direct elimination reaction. It is a direct elimination reaction. That means here C2H5 minus remove the proton from this carbon and leaving out the halogen, simultaneously takes place. Okay, E2 reaction proceeds through the transition state only. No formation of the carbanion, no formation of the carbocation. But in E1CB, that electron withdrawing group and poor leaving group favors the E1CB mechanism, that is proceeding through the formation of the carbanion. That means you are due to proceeding because of the acid-base reaction. Because of the acid-base reaction, those alpha hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium. So we can see the deuterium in the product. Okay, so that is a deuterium exchange in E1CB reaction. Okay, so like I think you are familiar with tautomerism. In tautomerism, alpha hydrogens, that means ionizable hydrogens, are replaced by the deuterium. Like this here also, you can see the deuterium in the product. For suppose here you can see one example. Okay, here double bond O withdrawing group, and next here OH. You know this one? Okay, you can see this type of substrate in a Aldol reaction. For suppose this one on heating with C2H5. Okay, or we can take the base like this, KOD and D2O, KOD and D2O. Here, this hydrogen is removed and OH is removed. But before that, here these two hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium. These three hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium. So, differently, CD3 and here double bond O, here pi bond, and this is a deuterium. Okay. So finally, we got the product that contains the four deuterium atoms. Initially, these two hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium. These three hydrogens are replaced by the deuterium. Then we can see finally elimination of the here. That means, of course, here this is the acidic proton. This hydrogen also replaced by the deuterium, but that is removed actually. Okay. So in this case, here OD and here D removed. So remaining 1D and here these three deuterium atoms. Okay. That's it. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel for more videos.